So, over here by this elevator, we can find an oil flask. And if you want to... get in behind that haunt. Here is the hardest spot in the catacombs. This guy just pivots back and forth. And we need to pick the lock on the chest, and there's also a piece of loot past him. So I'll handle the loot past him first, because the only way to do it is to time his turning correctly. And which direction he moves is pretty well randomized. I'll take a green alert from him to get the ruby ring in the back of the room. And you see he turns again. And I've made it safely back to the shadows. So, you need that ruby ring back there. And now, I'm going to try to pick the lock on the chest in two stages. Each time he turns. So there's one. Let's creep out. Left, left, right. For the first three. Back to the shadow. Just in time, it would seem. And then the last three stages are right, right, left. Or left, right, left. Sorry. Left, right, right. I just can't get it right at all. So now the lock is open. So when he turns around again, we'll open it. That'll green alert him. Get the three coppers inside, close it, and get back to the shadow. That's it. We haven't looted the Keeper Library yet, but that's the last place we go after we've done all of our other actual objectives. So for now, what we're gonna do is make our way to Garrett's place in South Quarter. I'm gonna go by way of the docks, so... just kinda have to hope for good timing on the zombie. Head east. Oh, he's decided to head the other direction for a while. That's fine. Doesn't really matter. Get out the entrance door and back up the stairs. We kind of have to hope for good timing here, too. Wait until the hammerite is passed. Hopefully he won't notice the door open. He will not. That's good.
Hello.
Let's try and get eyes on the priest. Good. Good. He's heading back. Oh, nope.
I shout.
He tricked me. I thought he was heading back to gloat over the tithing bowl, but no, he was headed towards me. Just couldn't see him. I'm gonna leave by way of the main entrance.
Art thou well? Builder's blessing upon thee.
And now he is meditating at the tithing bowl, which is perfect. Now we just wanna make our way out across the main hall.
Tell them, Alfred. The Hammerites will never know your secret, and you'll get a proper burial too. That'll be my final gift to you.
So I prefer just to get in behind the patroller and head out the main entrance. That's it for Fort Ironwood.
Art thou well? How dost thou do?
You kind of want to get off to the side just so you can wall flatten and make sure none of the patrolling Hammerites nail you at the door. And then just wait for a good moment when everyone's backs are turned and get back out to the tavern. That worked out extraordinarily well.
Remember, death to anyone who might aid the betrayer.
So the way to the docks, which is the way I want to go, is to the east, under the fences area. And actually, I should show you the old quarter map, because you haven't seen it yet. We started at the Keeper compound in the west. You can get to Fort Ironwood directly through the graveyard, through an exit in the southwest. Fort Ironwood itself is here in the south. To the north is the exit to Stone Market. That's Stone Market proper. Here's the watch station. Here's the fences house. Here's Carmen's place. Across from Carmen's place in the northeast is the gate to Aldale. Here in the southeast, where we're headed, is the gate to the docks. And just because it's here, I'll show this to you even though we have nothing to do yet. Imposing behind the gate is the Shalebridge Cradle. Now finally, down here, in this little sewer, you see a pagan. He's got one of those tricky pagan lights walking around. What we need to do is twofold. Grab his wand. Well, let's read his journal first. Moonsday. I made them enchantings with my magicker wand to raising them undead again. Them hammerheads bees battling them all day and nights. Bees a good thinger I do. It bees keeper them from burying Frenzy Alfred in them's hammerfool graveyard. Bees I know want him buried in a hammer spot. Bees I want him to resting in goodsy earth where him's flesh can feeders them trees and vines. If I could just getting to them cornerstone and bees starting the greensy, then the hammery graveyard bees will turn greens and goodsy. Then we'll let friend Alfred bees buried there. But bees too risky, them hammers bees too manied. I bees must stay hidings in them sewers in old quarter for nows. It bees safe for me there, and I bees close enough to raising more undead with my magic or wand. Cloud's day. I bees not able to get to them cornerstone again. Bees a hammerhead near theirs. What bees I will do? At least I still havers my magic or wand. I bees will keep raisings them undead to stoppers them hammerheads. Them woodsy lord will guider me. Now right next to the book is a pile of copper coins, but the second I grab it, he's gonna yellow alert, so I have to be quick to get to a hiding spot.
Bees those things missing?
So reading that gave me a note. A pagan shaman wants to activate the pagan cornerstone in the old quarter graveyard so that plants will overrun the area. So this is the side mission, another one that we can only solve for either the hammers or the pagans.
If I bees you, then I bees very angry. I puttings a spell on you. All's woodsy well. Must be havers imaginings.
I want to pickpocket this guy as just a general rule for always seeking all the loot, but that has the effect of resolving the side mission in favor of the hammers. So that's why I decided to plant the sapling in the docks, just, I don't know, as a measure of balance. And planting the sapling, unlike cornerstones and rust mites, doesn't break any ghost rules or supreme ghost rules. So when we grab his wand...
My wand! Moves he something?
That's worth 200.
My eyes be tired, I guess.
Oh, but he green alerted to me. And I don't want that. So let's try again.
Oh, enough!
I think I should be able to grab it from the stairs without having to go down there and actually mess with him. Yes, good.
Hey, I be picky pocketed.
So there it is, his wand, the necromancer's wand, is worth 200, and that pickpocket bumps us all the way up to neutral with the Hammerites. Because we stopped the pagan shaman from regenerating zombies so the hammers could bury Alfred in the old quarter graveyard. And I think that's a good thing anyway. I'm no fan of zombies. So here by the docks gate is the third and final old quarter rust mite. That should be the 12th rust mite overall, if you're tracking them. And that's everything that's available for now. So I'm gonna head into the docks. I'll see you there. I'm sorry, folks, I forgot to hit record. All I did was, move out of the entrance. But as you can hear, the docks, like everywhere else, is now populated with enforcers who are starting fights, which is no good, but there's very little to be done about it. So I'll wait. I'll at least wait until the fight noises die down a little bit. So he's killed the city watchman here, but you'll notice that even though we can't use the door glyphs, the main entrance to South Quarter is now open, so all I have to do is head through there. Because we had the foresight to clear all of these areas before the enforcers showed up, our job is much easier. South Quarter, all we have to do is get to Garrett's building, but that won't be as easy as it sounds now that the enforcers are about. Let's get as far as we can before we hear any battle noises. There's always one patrolling the fountain area. So we'll need to avoid him.
Now our orders are to find the betrayer and the erase.
Nothing too difficult there, since I somehow prevented anyone from spawning into South Quarter. So, into Garrett's building we go. So here in Garrett's building, things get tricky if you didn't do the prep work I had us do earlier. So, our objective, go to your building in South Quarter as instructed by the mysterious note, is complete. So let's head up the stairs to Garrett's room. Thankfully, those lights are out.
Remember, death to anyone who might aid the betrayer.
So, it's vital that we have the lights out, because as soon as we open the door, staring right at us is a stationary enforcer. There's the normal keeper staring at the table to the right. So, it's impossible to get through the door without a green alert.
When he is found, cut off all possible escape routes.
It's impossible to get to this point without a green alert if the lights are on. Then, the best thing to do is get over the end table. Oh, Garrett started flying when I tried to make him crouch. We then want to get onto the fireplace, which we can still do in relative silence. Then we need to slide down next to the enforcer and creep back. Now you can do all of that without triggering alerts to get inside the place. You have to get all the way back to Garrett's practice room. I'm gonna play with his gold practice lock just because It's new, just bought it. It goes down, up, up, up left.
When we find Garrett, act swiftly. Do not
down,
hesitate. He has
down left, down left, and right. Although you might have noticed that it divides all the way into 16ths instead of 8ths, so gold locks are a lot more complicated to pick. Here in the practice room is another note. Garrett, you still have friends and allies. We are waiting in the graveyard in Old Quarter to speak with you. As proof of our good intentions, we have provided a quick means for you to evade the enforcers temporarily. Go to Black Alley and look for something unusual there. Our efforts to contact you have put us all in peril. That is all we can risk saying in this missive. Balance a friend. So, that completes the objective. After you enter your building, search around for clues about what's going on. The new objective, meet with the mysterious note writers in the graveyard in Old Quarter. The mysterious notes, and we got a new note too. The mysterious notes said to look for something unusual in Black Alley. It may help you evade the enforcers temporarily.
The Hammerites go, or the Pagans for that matter, before the council takes proper...
So, we now need to creep over beside the enforcer, and this is where we have to have the fireplace out. This step I could never accomplish without a...
What was that?
Garrett can mantle straight onto the fireplace mantle if he wants to, but I've never been able to accomplish that step of the exit without fully alerting the enforcer, unless I have the fireplace out.
Be aware. Garrett has proven he can be lethal.
Is that someone?
If only he would mantle on the first try, things would be so much easier. But he almost never does.
Hear that?
He'll always do it on the second try, but never the first. And we need him to do it on the first. Let's try once again. Beautiful. That's what we needed. So from there, uh-oh.
Did I hear a...
From there, if he's not a moron, he'll creep down onto the end table and not bump into his chair and stool and make more noise to alert the two guys standing in here. So let's try that once again. Good lord, son. You're killing me. Maybe I need to move faster.
A noise?
Let's try running. There we go. Made it onto the table.
Remember, death to anyone who might aid the betrayer.
So from there, you want to creep across the doorway into this corner, because that's where the shadow is. Straight in front of it, it'll illuminate. And last, I do want to close the door behind me. Bye, assholes! From there, we just exit the building like usual. So, let's take the note's advice and head to Black Alley. The easiest way to do that is to head through the attic with the climbing gloves. I got really lucky there, because it spawned me way out from the door, right where he could have seen me, but he happened to turn his head.
Remember, death to anyone who might aid the betrayer.
And thank goodness for that. So he'll turn right from here, which is good. It should let me get to this stairway and get up to the attic without incident. Still nothing and no one in the attic, which is the good news. We can head down from here. Shouldn't be any trouble. Now you'll notice there's one stationary enforcer watching out from Black Alley, but he's very easy to sneak around. So I find the easiest way to avoid making noise here is to jump across from the awning and then climb down this wall. You can then silently drop off into the old open sewer grate. Oh boy. This clown's gonna make trouble for me. And we want to move in behind the enforcer. Well, I don't know if he's gonna alert to me or not. Let's find out. Looks like not. Good. So a load zone has appeared at the end of Black Alley, which will take us straight to Fort Ironwood. And it'll drop us right into another cutscene, with plenty more foreshadowing. If you pay attention to the camera angles. What a Hammerite is doing out here, I have no idea.
I'm serious. I don't think this is right.
Keepers. Taking a break from trying to kill me?
Not all keepers believe you are guilty, Garrett.
But neither had we the evidence to alter the outcome of your trial.
The trial was a disgrace. Orlando's not fit. He knows he must replace Kataka, so he plans to promote that child, Gamal, to the position of interpreter.
So you formed your own little club.
There are others, too. The Keeper hierarchy is in flux. We know Orlan tried to frame you, but we cannot discern his motives.
That's easy. Orlan is the Brethren and betrayer, and he knew Kataka was on to him. He needed to kill her before she announced his name, and thought he could get rid of me at the same time.
That is only one of many possibilities, Garrett.
He has suppressed all inquiries into the Clock Tower prophecy. Have you heard? From above, the rubble forms an arrow, and it points directly at the Keeper Library.
The evil one will be pointed to.
It is as if someone actively seeks to bring the Dark Age upon us. There is a corruption. Whenever the glyphs...
Keeper Artemis hasn't been seen since before the trial. He confided in me that he no longer knew who to trust. He acted strangely, so secretive.
But he was right. There is no way to know who to trust. The degree to which the glyphs...
Orland fears you still, and he will until the enforcers bring him your corpse.
He has used a binding glyph to seal every glyph door in the whole city. He is watching all of us. Until you are found, no one is allowed to enter or leave the compound.
We've been using Orland's own secret tunnel. It connects the compound to his office in the library. There's much danger, but it is the only way we can meet without being...
Perhaps we can help you. The Keeper assassins won't have given up, and...
You've helped me already.
Why? What do you intend to do?
Find some proof that Orland is guilty. That shouldn't be too hard.
Oh? Where do you think you will find this proof, Garrett?
Oh, I guess there's a Hammerite in the graveyard because I solved the zombie problem by stealing the Necromancer's wand. So, like I said, there's the grave of Penelope Oddbody. May you find the peace in death that you never found in life. And I wonder about something. Yeah, I didn't think so. So let's quick load right quick. There is one new thing as a result of completing the little side mission as I did. And that is here where we met with the keepers. You see a statuette on this grave. Alfred Hurley, beloved brother of Alyssa, a devout citizen and pious woman who dost attend services most regular. May the builder find a place in his house for him. There's a gold statuette worth 50. That's it. So we can head out the exit directly to Old Quarter from the graveyard. But, oh yeah, let's see what happened to our objectives. We completed meet with the mysterious note writers in the graveyard in Old Quarter. And our new objective is return to the Keeper Library in Stone Market Plaza, then find the secret tunnel which leads to the Keeper Compound. Excellent. So this'll spit us out in Old Quarter. And the hammers are neutral to me now, but I'm still in their territory until I get clear of this street. So, just wait until their backs are to me and run from shadow to shadow. Until I manage to get by them.
Indeed, hello!
Once that tunnel's clear, which shouldn't take too long from this moment, I'll run out into it. Get back out into the street. Now, it's a more direct route to the Keeper Library to head through Stone Market, but Stone Market proper with the Enforcers is a huge mess. So instead,
he will use the shadows. He will use stealth. He will learn.
So I am gonna head through the docks, through South Quarter, to Stone Market Plaza. That's far easier. You really just want to avoid Stone Market proper if you can. It's crazy. Maybe she's already settled down regarding all of the corpses, but somehow I doubt that. So, out we go, back into the docks. Well, this is a special moment. We are now recording past where my initial playthrough ended because my computer crashed, so we're finally actually in new territory for those of you who watched my old playlist. Anyway, let's just bust it on out of here and get back to South Quarter quick as we can. Head straight through South Quarter to Stone Market Plaza. Oh my gosh.
Better wake up.
I think that was just a green alert.
Looking at nothing and jumping too.
Yes, it was just a green alert. Thank goodness. This is what I hate. I hate having to take the main entrances because they spawn you right in view of anyone who happens to be patrolling there. And if your timing is bad, you're well and truly screwed. Thankfully, he didn't yellow alert. Otherwise, we would have had to go through Stone Market proper instead, and that would really, really be a pain in the butt.
Orders are to find the betrayer and the erase.
So let's just get behind this enforcer.
Did I see?
Whatever, F you and your green alert. Well, no. I'm just getting impatient because day 6, as you might have noticed, is taking forever. But we really are near the end now, which is good. Let's not take a green alert. We don't have to. Let's hit the crawl space instead. Oh, that didn't work either. Let's do go fast, but make for the crawl space. That should work. There we go, that's what I wanted. Now I should be able to.
He will use the shadows. He will use stealth.
There we go. With that done, we'll head through to Stone Market Plaza, which we haven't been to yet, so it'll have its initial encounter with the enforcers while we're here. We need to get to the Keeper Library again, and as before, the...
Something just move. Nothing there.
I think he green alerted to the enforcer and not to me. It'll be...
Wow! I'll teach you!
Still there, eh?
Chair.
Can't help making more noise, can you?
Now everybody's on high alert, thanks to the enforcers. He actually saw me. I was gonna say, I don't think I had saved yet inside Stone Market Plaza. Well, I was hoping to sneak behind people, but we may just have to wait for the enforcer encounters to be resolved before we can do anything else. I was at least hoping to make it past this city watchman and the street patrollers.
Nothing there.
Maybe we can. It'd sure be nice.
Your interference must end.
All right, good. We made it here without any alerts. Let's get up here without any alerts.
Gotcha, Taffer.
Good grief. Yeah. I was running from somewhere else to find the enforcers and he caught me, so... Better wait in the shadow at the bottom of the ramp until he gets to where he's trying to go to join the fight.
Yikes!
Oh, yeah, okay, here he comes. Thank you. Okay. Let's get to the top of the ramp now. Let's head left, see what we can see.
I hear someone.
So obviously we're near the library now, but I should point out that it's guarded by two enforcers.
Someone is close. I am searching.
So boy, it would be grand if they both headed down there. Probably not going to be that simple.
You just
quick, are you?
Extremely painful.
Well, I didn't really want that, but...
I must find the betrayer.
Okay, with their backs turned, I should be able to get around the corner to the next set of shadows, at the very least.
He might use the shadows.
So you want to get to this wall, if you can. Flatten. Manage that without any commentary, which is good. Now you'll see, this guy pivots back and forth. We need to wait for him to face directly south, and then get through. Damn! I don't quite know how doable this move will be with him on high alert from being in those fights. The enforcers are such a pain. I hate them. Uh-oh. Thank goodness we were truly in a perfect shadow. He patrols up and down this street, much like the city watchman did before he was summarily executed by these guys. I think he heard me running on the stone and then turned to look at me, so maybe if I just stay crouched, keep it nice and slow. I've never managed to avoid a green alert getting around this corner. That's the best I've been able to do. So, to get into the library...
Aha! I know you're the culprit.
You disrupt my mission. I feel something is nearby.
We need to just climb the wall and head in through this window. Into the Keeper Library. With that, thank God we're done with the enforcers. But, we still have to loot the Keeper Library, and it's harder than before, because I want to clear the Forbidden Library. All the respawning loot is still in there, but I can't use the door glyphs to take the secret entrance, so I have to get through the front door, past the guy staring right at it. Fortunately for all of us, I have figured out a way to do it. The first thing we need to do is get to the door over there. Easiest way, I think, is creep down this staircase, head left around behind this guy, through these shadows. Be careful not to bump chairs or anything like that. Everyone in here is hostile to us now.
Tell them about the problem I had with the Trilogem glyph?
Then we can open this door, to the Forbidden Library and head through. Now, there's the front door guard. He doesn't move unless he's alerted. If we put out the torch, we can get by him. But if we put out the torch in normal fashion...
There. I know you were there.
He read alerts.
What I don't know is who.
Which shatters my ghost. Fortunately, I have figured out a way to do this. Believe it or not, gas arrows are not useless to a ghoster. What gas arrows can also do, besides knock people out, is silently extinguish a torch. If we aim it just right, it will put out the torch without any alert from him and without knocking him out, so our ghost stays intact. Now, this is tricky, and I want to do it in phases. Creep up next to him. That's the first step. He'll green alert.
A fleeting glance.
So wait for that to settle.
Where was I?
When that's done, we can move over to the door, which will result in another green alert, but that should be all, if we're careful. Or maybe not.
Again?
There it is.
So many distractions lately.
Once we get to here... Another quick save's in order. The door itself picks open with the same combination as the landlord. Left down, left up, down. Now when we open the door, he'll green alert.
I must find my concentration again.
I'm sorry, I need to do that from the right side. What's interesting is...
You have to wait for his greed alert to settle before you close the door.
Otherwise, he'll upgrade to a yellow and start searching for you. So, let's head over to the right of the door. Open it from here.
Was that a noise? There is no sound that I can perceive.
Wait for the green alert to settle, get through the door, and then close it. And we've made it into the Forbidden Library at the cost of one gas arrow. So, it's the same five pieces of loot as always. Rare book here on the first level. The guard patrolling here just has a purse. We will, of course, want to grab. There's no one else up here, so... I didn't want to green alert him, though. Unlike previous trips, there's no one else to worry about, so we can follow him as tightly as we want to. As long as we want to. No one else is ever going to spot us. And let's just get the purse. 50 gold, as always.
Where can the ancestries have been filed? Nothing seems to be in its proper... but who could possibly pickpocket me?
With that done, we'll head up to the third floor, where we can grab another rare book off of this table. And just get in behind this guy. Again, there's no one up here on this top balcony, which is nice. So we can bust right through to get the gold goblet, the rare book, and the last gold goblet out of the secret room. Having accomplished all of that, we will reclose the secret passage. Make our way back down. Wait for him to cross, and then move out behind him.
Permission is a long time coming to access the secondary stacks. Very slow. What could possibly justify such a delay?
just move across behind him and get back down to the first floor. We need to move back out the front door as carefully as we came in.
New robes, I see. Somewhat... There is no sound that I can perceive.
And we need to creep back to our spot beside him.
So I knew it.
I do have more trouble with this move. It seems to matter which way Garrett is turned and facing and all sorts of weird stuff, but don't worry, we can get across as we got in.
It's back. My eyes fail to see anything now.
There we go, just a green alert.
Again?
A second green alert, so we'll wait for that to settle.
I must find my concentration again.
And last, we should take one more while we creep along the wall.
Some movement. So many distractions lately.
And that's it.
Why do my reports fall on deaf ears?
We're done with the Forbidden Library. So we need to go. Navigate this front room again.
Before the council takes proper notice.
Which remains pretty easy to do. It's down the stairs, behind this guard, through these shadows. Do be aware of the guard on the level above us. Then up this staircase here, which we should be able to accomplish with no alerts from anyone. I don't think that was a green alert. It was not. That's good. Now we need to get through this, I guess, southwestern door. There is a guard who patrols back here.
Saw something.
I thought I had timed that better. It's possible and is, in fact, quite easy to get through there with no alerts at all. So that's what we're gonna try for. A little more speed getting to this corner. He should pass us by without incident. Finally, don't forget, in this chamber, the copper ring on the table. Get that, and then head up the ladder. Now the patroller will yellow alert to the missing copper ring this time. Don't worry too much about that.
Missing.
Cross this hallway, be wary of one unarmed keeper up here, but once you're across this hallway, you're clear. The two guards that are normally stationed at Orland's office are gone, so we can finally pick open his door. Left down, upright, left, upright, down left. Inside here, what can we find? Well, very little, actually. There's one note to read. Orland, your concerns about allowing Garrett among us are well-founded. I, too, have grave concerns. Could he be the Brethren and Betrayer? If only the Glyphs would give up their secrets more readily. Watch him carefully. A thief could do irreparable damage to our situation. We must guard our precious knowledge. See. So... here, finally, is the entrance to the next mission. So, that's it for Day 6, the arrival of the Enforcers, our first chance to explore Old Quarter and Fort Ironwood. All is taken care of. We managed to perfect thief it. We were well off of Supreme. And that's it for now. I will see you guys next time for Of Brethren and Betrayers, the next mission in the Keeper Compound. Bye-bye.